Hey everyone, welcome to the news review of the Falcon and the Winter Soldier episode 4. The whole world is watching. In this one, Zemo is still the main attraction. The guy is just charming. He helps finding Mercantile and yeah, Falcon try to have a decent conversation, but Bully Cap, I'm going to call John Walker the Bully Cap, interrupted and this goes mess way from there. Lot of action happens and somehow Zemo shot Mercantile and got his hand on the serum. Anyone who would find this might inject themselves and became superhuman. But Zemo is unique and he's got certain principles, so he destroyed almost everyone. But Bully Cap interrupted and got one. As he's ashamed because Wakandians beat him badly because of his awful behaviors. To be honest, he's no way worthy of the shield, but he's got 3 medals, so yeah. He injected the serum and became super strong. It doesn't show in this episode, but we figured it out when. We figure it out because he's got super strong. And again, when they faced the Flag Smasher, the right side team, Falcon, the Winter Soldier, and the Bully Cap, Mercantile kills Bully Cap's sidekick. So because of that, Bully Cap became furious and killed one of the members of the Flag Smasher, and the whole world watches as he do it by putting blood stain on the shield. So far, the whole show is complicated. No one is hero or villain. It's not like one of these MCU movies. This is, yeah, very complex. A part of Mercantile makes sense and part of her don't. Winter Soldier was a villain turned hero, so a part of him also cast as a villain, count as a villain, so it's lifelike. People have some part awful to make others meaningful. Zemo disappear while everyone's got busy. He's the villain, so he has to, or otherwise Wakandians would have killed him anyway. The entire show is about who deserves power and who has power and its uses and abuses. So far it's way better than WandaVision, and I hope it keeps getting better.